questions about today's game and Minnesota game only.
Coach, the slow start, what do you think that layover, not making the tournament, 10 days off, just you guys really, that first half and first 5-10 minutes of the second half didn't look like yourselves.
Yeah, I thought, you know, honestly, I thought like the first 10 minutes were pretty poor. And then I thought we actually settled in and played pretty well. I just thought their shot making was like, I looked at one part of the second half and they were like 9 for 13 from three. I'm doing the quick math in my head that Drake was 11 for 18. I'm like, last, you know, 20 for 31 from three for the opponents. I mean, that's hard to do. I mean, they bank a three in, you know, that, like I said, Hudson's, you know, I mean, we were going to put Robbie on him, play drop. I mean, he makes less than half a three a game. He makes three right away. You know, Phelps, you know, makes two. He's a 21% shooter, doesn't make a three a game. I mean, some of it was just there. They were just playing great. And I thought our offense was pretty good. But in the second half, I didn't think our energy was good at all. I thought the first 10 minutes of the game and the first, you know, couple minutes of the second half, we weren't very good. And then all of a sudden, you know, we kind of settled in. And once we did, I thought, you know, like I said, at the beginning of the game, I thought we just didn't look – it looked like they were just so much more athletic than we were. And maybe that's the 10 days off. I think more than anything, we just looked out of sync, out of sorts. But once we settled in, I thought we actually played pretty good. Even at halftime, I told them, you know, we had 40 points, and I think we were 4 for 17 from three. But I probably liked, you know, 14 or 15 of those looks. You know, it wasn't like we were getting – Robbie got four wide-open looks, and we just didn't make them. But I said, hey, we scored 40 points, didn't shoot it well. We just keep, you know, moving it. We got to guard better.
Go ahead. Coach, you know, normally running 6-7 guys deep in the game, but you ran 9 pretty early, you know, with Forrest and Miller.
Yeah.
You know, talk about that.
Just trying to buy minutes. It was a good game for Derek because they're so big. You know, Mace, you know, has been shooting it great in practice. And so Isaiah got his second foul. Just thought that we were getting some clean looks. And Mason gives us, you know, if they had a guy out there, you know, size-wise, he could match up with pretty easily. And, you know, Mace, the guy that, you know, is one of our better shooters, thought he might get a good catch-and-shoot opportunity. He did on the wing. He missed it, but he got a great look. You know, and I just were able to, you know, we're able to throw those guys, you know, kind of depends game to game, but, you know, Jake and Jabbo are going to play, and then after that, it's kind of, you know, depending on what the game was, but Swope's second foul, and then just their size, you know, we couldn't play Jabbo at the five unless Hudson was at the five and play small ball. The other two guys were probably a little too big for him to guard.
Rick, normally Jason's not the focal point of the offense, but for about the first 30 minutes, everything was going through him in the scoring. He seemed as different tonight, the look in his eye. Did you see a different Jason Kent out there?
I mean, I think he, you know, Jason's a guy like, I mean, we don't call anything for him ever. You know, like he is as good as there is at like leveraging the system to be able to like do what he does best. You know what I mean? Like Jason made all those plays on his own. I mean, there was cuts, there was offensive rebounds, there was transition, there was paint to great, you know, threes from the corner, which is where he generally gets his threes. He was relentless on the offensive glass. He ran in transition. He got multiple cuts. I mean, probably got four of his baskets were on cuts, probably four or five, you know, and so he just does what he does. He leverages the system in a great way, and he understands, like, you know, how to utilize what he does best. He's a guy that has developed in a guy that he's able to do what he does best all the time. And you look at his numbers, 11 for 12 from the field, 11 for – I mean, he scored 35 points on 12 shots. I mean, that's incredible. And the efficiency level, but that's been him all year. I mean, like I've said many times, you know, you could debate on who's the best player, and probably people won't, you know, go to him immediately. They'd say maybe Ryan Conwell or Robbie. But Jason's our most important player because of what he brings to the table. I thought he was all over the glass, got us extra possessions, did exactly what he does. He just scored, and he was opportunistic in the way he does it. And you can do it without having to run anything for him, and he gets 35 points. That's pretty incredible.
Go ahead. It was mentioned earlier about the Drake comeback, which is, in your eyes, what do you feel like was the difference tonight that let you not only come back to tie it up, but then just to control the game and end up finishing it off?
Yeah, I mean, you know, help that Tucker DeVries wasn't out there. you know, so that helped. You know, I mean, I think it's a make or miss game. I thought, you know, we went zone there in the second half. We were down, got down 12 or so. I thought the zone kind of stymied some of their stuff. I thought we were able to get stops. I thought our rebounding late was great. We got beat up on the glass early. We went a little bigger with how we put Job on there for Swope just to get some more size in there, you know. And I thought it was that. And then offensively, I mean, we just made timely shots. I mean, you know, you look at him, and we had, I mean, the offensive rebound play late there where, you know, we shoot the air ball, but Robbie gets it, you know, flips it up, and then the ball gets tipped by Kent to Ryan. Ryan gets fouled. I mean, we had some big-time plays. Ryan stuck a huge three there late. I mean, you know, all those were – we had some big-time plays. The cut Jay Kent made, Robbie found him for the backdoor layup. I mean, Robbie had a great shooting night. You know, he's 2 for 11, but, you know, he gets 7 assists, 8 rebounds, and, you know, and I thought after – you know, benched him early in the second half because, you know, the defense, I thought his defense the last 18 minutes was far, or whatever, when he came back in, was far superior.
Jack.
Coach, you know, you talked a little bit about the crowd already, but when you guys made your run, it felt like you had a 6-man on defense with how loud they were. Just talk about, you know, how they kind of impacted you and kind of fueled you tonight, and also how excited you guys are to get another game this weekend.
Yeah, the crowd's been, I mean, you know, all year. I mean, it's been that like symbiotic relationship of, you know, the way they've, you know, lifted us, supported us, wrapped their arms around us. Like, you know, our guys understand that's very uncommon. Like the way Terre Haute supports their team, the way they care about basketball, how loud they got. Like when we were making that comeback, you know, we were down, I think maybe 10, and we started rallying back. And I mean, that was as loud as I've heard it, you know. I mean, it was unbelievable, the energy and the electricity in the building. And, you know, that's just, you know, that's what part of what's made this whole year so special, and really even the last 2 years. I mean, it's just, you know, we had some of that last year, but this year has been a whole different level. But this is the epicenter of basketball, Indiana, and Terre Haute's about as good as it gets in terms of people that they love it. They support it. They're passionate about Indiana State, but they're certainly passionate about Indiana State basketball. And that connection doesn't exist in a lot of places. We all, every player, every coach realizes, like, you know, how lucky we are to be a part of that.
Question over here, all right.
Coach, obviously not take away from huge victory tonight, but you have a Big Ten school in Minnesota coming here on the weekend. Just talk about just the magnitude of Big Ten playing Missouri Valley here at the Holman Center. And then just, they obviously got the huge win against Butler, who was a higher-ranked team than them.
Yeah, I mean, you know, SMU's, you know, going to the ACC next year, so you got, you know, and now you get Minnesota coming in, and that's awesome. You know, these are opportunities that you would never get except for, you know, being in the postseason. So, you know, an opportunity to play SMU on your home court, opportunity to play Minnesota on your home court. This would never happen in a non-conference, even though it should. So, you know, it's our guys, you know, you could see tonight, like, the competitive will and disposition they showed, like, we'll be ready. Now, Minnesota's very good, but, you know, whatever, this weekend, this place, I know our fans will be ready, and I have no doubt our players will be equally as ready. It should be an unbelievable environment here on, whatever, you know, Saturday or Sunday, whenever we play.
Last question.
What were your thoughts on just the chants from the student section as you guys, the "We Want Schertz" chants as you guys were walking off the court?
I thought it was "We Love Schertz." Could be "We Want." I don't know. But, you know, I thought the love that the fans have shown me is very, very much reciprocated. You know, like that aspect of being the coach here is by far the coolest thing, you know, is how much people care, how much they care about you. And I care, that care is two ways. Like, the love is a two-way street. Like, I genuinely love the people here. We love the community. We love the students. You know, we have been, you know, for 3 years completely invested in this place, mind, body, soul, and to have that reflected back to you is always kind. I didn't hear those chants as much in year one. Might have been with Gone at the end of it or whatever, but no, even back when we lost 20 games, like, people here were treating us well. They're like, "Hey, we're gonna get it together, we're gonna get going." And my number one thing is to give the fans the program they deserve, you know, because they deserve the best. Like, I really think that, like, Terre Haute, Indiana State, the Forest, the students that come out, the community, I mean, they deserve the absolute best, and I feel that responsibility. I know our players do too. You know, we feel the responsibility to give them the very best program we can. We love them, and that is very much reflected back towards them. So, appreciate it.
Coach, thank you.
Thank you, guys.
SMU's in.